Hello, welcome to this video. My name is Paul van Gils from Ardenchro, working there for already 9 years, mainly the Netherlands and a few countries around the Netherlands. In this video, I'm going to explain a few things. I'm going to inform you about the company history, the national sunlight in the greenhouse, how to create more light in autumn and winter, and the application methods necessary for applying our products. Our company is founded in 1986, starting with the DS4. And during the years until now, we introduced several products like the RadioSol in 1990. During the years, RadioHeat and RadioFuse entered the horticultural market, RadioFuse IR and RadioFlex Blue as well. And in 2016, we started introducing more light products. And we're happy to tell you that during 2020, we can inform everybody about the possibilities of year-round shading or having more light. And that's what I'm going to explain you a little bit more in this video. Ardenchro is not only working in horticultural, it's our main. But beside that, we are growing very fast in line marking products, specific line marking lines. In the Netherlands, when the growers are looking for the television for soccer on Sunday evening, about 70% of what they see on television are lines of Ardenchro. In other countries, we are very busy selling and promoting soccer and line marking lines. So hopefully in your country, you can see our lines on the television as well in the future. We are also busy in offices and industry by making the roofs white during summer and spring to achieve more or lower temperatures inside. It's possible we measured about 7 degrees lower temperatures in offices. So there is more question about that because of the high temperatures and light levels over the last 3-4 years. That's what we do. But what we do in horticultural, where you work, is we provide everybody with shading materials. We have 5 main products, which we start already with in spring, with the applications. And in summer, we have 6. RadioSol, the product which is most common, shading light and temperature. The RadioHeat, reflecting temperature, providing more light for the plants. The RadioFuse is a product which is mainly making the light diffuse, scatter light on the glass. The RadioFuse IR is a product which is reflecting temperature, making light diffuse and shading a little bit of the light. So a combination of the 3 products mentioned before. The RadioFlex Blue is a product which we can achieve longer stems, specific for roses. Gerberas, Alstroemerias have interest in that as well. And when you have a really hot summer, spray chalk is a product which is applied a lot the last few years. It's only last till the next rain shower and then it rains off. That's what we are most know about as company. But we also provide products where you have more light in winter. 4 products. When you start in autumn, you want to have the coatings off and you do that with Radio Clean. In winter, you have crop rotation. You can clean your glass with GS4. And after that, on anti-condense application on the inside and anti-reflect on the outside. You have natural sunlight in the greenhouse. The sun is the most cheapest way to have light in your glasshouse, to warm up your glasshouse, but there are moments that you have too much. This is a graph we look a lot to. In the middle, you can see what we see with our own eyes, and the rest is for a part what a plant sees. Plant sees UV, he sees par, near, and that's okay when it's not too much, but too much, a plant gets stressed and damaged. And what you want is an optimal level to grow your plant best. Too much or too little light. For this, in this case, in London, we see that you have average light levels, maximum light levels, and your daytime temperature. That's okay. Everybody wants to go to the beach in summer when it's hot and warm and sunny, but a plant, he cannot do anything when it's too hot or when there is too much light. For instance, a tomato can have 1800 joules maximum in summer. So there are moments that there is too much light. When there is too much light, it's possible to shade. You can see here with the red block that these moments are perfect to get the plant less stressed by applying a coating on top of the glass. There are several possibilities I just mentioned, and if you want to have any information about that, you can always ask your distributor or me what is best. But in winter, you have less light. You need more light, but it's dark. The angle of the sun is low. And for these specific moments, which we are going to the next few months, we have products which I'm going to tell you and inform you a little bit about. Coatings for autumn and winter. So you as a grower had too much light the last summer and you applied a coating. You want to remove that, of course. How are you going to do that? We have the Ready-Clean for that. And the Ready-Clean is a cleaner you apply on the glass, and it's working like a key in a lock of a door, which opens the door. If you have a coating on top, apply the Ready-Clean. The coating will get loose of the glass and the rain will get it off. It sounds easy, but it's easy like I'm saying. You want to have more light, you want to have it back after summer, and that's possible. The product is suitable for glass, polycarbonate, plastic film, so almost on all possibilities, possible surfaces possible to apply. We have three versions of the Ready-Clean because the Ready-Fuse and the Ready-Fuse IR are more sticky than the rest. So we have Ready-Clean for Ready-Sol, Ready-Heat and Ready-Flex Blue. We have the Ready-Clean for diffuse coatings for the Ready-Fuse and the Ready-Fuse IR. And we have a special Ready-Clean DT, Dosatron, for the applications and washings with machines. Washing machines with the application possibilities with an arm on the side, they can apply the product in spring, but they also can clean, and therefore we made a special Dosatron mixing system. The outside, not everybody is coating the outside, so there are people with just glass, and not everybody is cleaning the outside. Like you see here on the part of the photo, you hardly see any green glass like this. It's rare, luckily, but it's still possible to clean and that doing that every year. We see now that this glass cleaner is used more common on the outside, and it's very easy to use because you apply it on the glass and immediately rinse off with a lot of water and your glass gets clean. It's very easy to apply. You need dry weather, but you also need to realize that you need no sunny weather, no windy weather. So the weather circumstances outside need to be cloudy weather, a little bit almost raining, and that's the most ideal weather moments to use. If you have a wide span, it's always difficult to clean the outside. And in this case, with the application of GS4, it's working very well. Apply the GS4 with one person and let the other one walking behind it immediately. So there is only about 10-15 minutes time difference between it. Don't apply the GS4, go back for a cup of coffee and then take it out with water. Do it with both together after each other, and then you get the best results. And if you get the best results on a Venloan greenhouse, it's also possible to apply AdReflect after that on the nursery. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about it later. The insight is getting very important more and more as well, because it's a breeding ground for diseases and bacteria, and we see that in the tomatoes nowadays with the brown virus, and mostly used during crop rotation. It's very quick, you don't need a lot of GS4, and it's damp-free, February-free. So if you use it, the plants which might be in the area don't have any problems with it. The thing is that all the algae and everything outside inside of the glass applied with GS4 will get out after cleaning with water. The thing we need to mention is that if you grow bulbs or you grow eggplants, it's not advisable to use it in that case. Just like I mentioned with the outside, watch it for the inside. You really need to have cloudy weather, no sunny weather. Don't open your vents. Don't ventilate your glass after before you are clear and ready. You need to have a high humidity, because if the humidity is low, it will dry out too quick. If you finish the glass clean, that would be an ideal situation to apply anti-condensation product on the inside. Because in a lot of situations, people don't hardly see it, because when you're on the path and your glass is very high, you don't see often that there is a lot of fog condensation on the inside. On this picture, you see the part where there is 9% light reflection, that you see a lot of minimum droplets on the inside, and that takes out a lot of light. Sometimes even 9% of light occurring to the University of Wageningen. We have a product, anti-condens, and if you apply that on a dry surface, then and it's dry out before the night is entering, the days, the year after, you see what you see on the other part of the photo. You see minimum of drops, and the rest is a water film. So the energy of a drop, it will go away, and a drop will flow in a film and go to the gutter. In practice, it will show. It will be shown like this. This is from a client of mine in the Netherlands. You see the white part where the measurement is hanging. That's all condensation on the inside, and the rest of the glass is clean, is clear, and that's been applied with the anti-condens. In this case, we measured 7% more light than the part which is almost white because of all the drops. So the product, it's very easy to apply, and after the application, you have real benefits. So if you want to increase your light and don't want to have droplets, apply the anti-condens after cleaning the glass on a dry surface, and then you get a film. Once you have that, you improve your light transmission and have less drops. Less drops on your cutting trays, less mold in your young plant production, less chemicals needed to change all the damage the drops take care of. And if you have a tunnel with plastic film, you know that when you have drops on the inside and there is a little bit of wind, it easily falls on your plants, particularly soft fruit. They have a lot of problems with that. So if you have that on the inside of plastic film, the drops will flow to the sides and you have less drops on your plants. In all, you have more and better quality, and you can grow your cultivation longer in tunnels and in glass. It's ideal to apply on during crop rotation, on dry glass and on plastic film. And we are happy to inform you more when you have more questions about that on your nursery. When you have glass, particularly Venlo glass, then we are having a product which we can provide you on the glass, and you can achieve 2.5–3% more light after the application. And it looks like this on this graph. The gray line is the glass, and the blue line is the glass with the end to reflect. The reason why I'm showing this always to everybody is because we get a lot of questions that you are a shading company and you shade light. So how can you inform me that end to reflect don't shade anything? This is the graph we used the most. You can see that 2.5% more light is also 2.5% more UV, also 2.5% more infrared. So in all, you get more light. The more light is getting with a low angle. So if you apply it on the glass, you have a clean glass, you have a contractor or a washing machine with an application possibility yourself, then it's possible to apply it after cleaning the glass. You need 1,200 liter a hectare of the product, and it will be there for about two years. The product works perfect with when the angle of the sun is low. So that starts from August, and the optimum is until the end of March. And the angle of the sun is then the lowest. The sun is not getting very high anymore, particularly in December. But it starts always every day on a low part. Only in summer it's getting up very quick, but still you have some profit of it as well. So it's working for 2 years because of the less condensation on the outside because of the product. You have less algae grow on the outside. And you can combine it with our Ready Systems coatings and Ready Clean. So if you have too much light in summer, you can apply the products on top of the on the outside of the glass. You're shaded, and you ensured your plants of having less stress. After cleaning with Ready Clean, the end to reflect will be there again, and you have the benefit of that in winter. We have two Dutch growers asked about their experience, Paul Moerman and a cucumber grower in the south of the Netherlands. We made YouTube films of them. It's in Dutch, sorry for that. But for instance, Paul Moerman informed us that without doing anything crop-wise, after the application of end to reflect, he harvests 4% more kilos of peppers in the Netherlands. So that's really interesting after the application of that product. But there are more possibilities to improve your reflection on the inside of the glass, that's by painting your pipes. The thing is, you achieve more even heat radiation after the pipe painting. This product is really old. We sell it a lot in the UK, but we sell it more in Asia and Russia. And what you do is that after the application, you have more even heat radiation, but you also have less corrosion and it's looking more white. A lot of pipes are getting rusty during the time, and you want to have a nice looking glass greenhouse. And the positive thing of the product we have is it is solvent free, so you can use it 365 days a year. So if someone is free, not doing anything, and you think, well, I want to have more white pipes in my nursery, you can do it all year round. Let them paint your pipes. And you can also always ask your distributor about this product. Maybe they have it in stock. But how are you going to apply all these products? So what we've done, we made some examples to show you how it's been done. The conditions always need to be good. So a surface needs to be dry and clean before applicate. The temperature needs to be about 10 to 20 degrees. Not too sunny, not too cloudy, not really a high humidity, and not need to be dry too quick but it just needs to dry. After the application, we expect of everybody that the nut will rain being within one day. And if you apply something on the inside, we expect that there is no crop underneath the glass. When you do something outside, take care that the humidity is lower than 80%, because otherwise our products don't dry out like we want on the outside. And we need to have a proper ventilation, both applying products on the inside or on the outside after. The application methods inside, when you use the GS4, apply the GS4 on the inside, let it work for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then use a lot of water to rinse it off. Just a lot of water. The amount of GS4 on the inside takes care on how dirty is your glass on the inside. So the most people are using 100 to 200 liters of the product per hectare maximum. You can apply the anti-condens on the inside. First, clean it with, for instance, GS4 on the inside, and then apply it with a really fine mist. So not, if I always say that it has to stick on the glass on the inside. I don't want to see drops falling down applying while the application of anti-condens. You need about 60 to 100 liters of the product, and in total, you need to apply about 1,000 to 1,200 liters on the glass on the inside per hectare. Pie paint, you can do with one bucket from 15 liters, approximately 1,000 square meters, 1,000 meters of a 51 millimeter pipe. And then you can do that with a with a special pipe paint roller, or do it by hand. A lot of people do it by hand in the Netherlands, but I know there are special rollers for it as well. On the outside, use the Reduclean. Apply it, let it there, and if you wash it yourself, you need to wait a minimum of 15 to 30 minutes, and then you can wash it off. If you apply it and you want to do it by rain, that's also possible. Take care that it rains, and we have the preference that it will rain within 3 days, because then we know that the concentration of the Reduclean is high on the outside, and you need approximately 250 liters of the Reduclean per hectare for the use on the outside. If you want to clean it with GS4, when you don't use the coating, just clear glass, apply the GS4 and let it soak for 5 to 10 minutes, and then wash it off with a lot of water by hand with a hose, so that one, just like I mentioned, is applying the GS4 and the other one is walking behind it with a hose, or with a washing machine on the way back after the application. And also here, think about 100 to 200 liter per hectare product, and that's enough. And then you have really clear glass. If you've done both, Reduclean or GS4, and you have a Venlo nursery and you want to apply the anti-reflect, certified contractors are able to do that, to apply it, or when you have an own machine with application possibilities, you are able to apply it with 1200 liters ready anti-reflect ready to use. So we have boxes, we send them over to you as a grower, and then it need to be done by machines. It's possible to apply 1200 liters, and then you can have 2.5 to 3% more light during winter, spring and autumn. That's a little bit about it for me. If you have any questions about this presentation, let me, us or your distributor know, and then we get back with the answers, or visit you whenever it's possible. Here are my details. If you, we have a newsletter. If you want to subscribe for a newsletter, go to the ReduSystems.com, and then you get regularly a newsletter with a lot of information. or send me a mail or call me, send me a text with some questions, or invite me for a visit on your nursery. And for the rest, thank you very much for your time, and I hope to see you very soon, and have a good day. Thank you. Bye-bye.